Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Mitch Rapp Plays. Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3. This is Dark Souls 1. I think it's episode 10, 11, 12. I don't know. I've lost count. But here we are. We're back at Firelink Shrine. Last episode, we defeated the spider crazy lady. Chaos Witch Qualeg? Qualeg? Qualeg, maybe? Just so you know, I did do some exploration in Blighttown. I just thought, you know, I'm gonna run around down here, and because I'm probably gonna die a lot, it's super framey, like I don't want to put that on camera, it's not a good experience. But do know that we did pick up a couple things, and let's see here, we got a plank shield and a great sword. They'll both be in here. A great club. Did I pass it? No. Oh, we upgraded our Black Knight greatsword to +2. It's fucking legit, doing 475 damage. Let's see, where is the great club? The great club's pretty good. 135 just straight out of the gate. Does scale B, B with strength, which is good for us since we're primarily a strength build. We are only a strength build at this point. That might change in the future. Physical is 135. We get a bonus of 103. Giant tree branch serves as a wooden club, smashes enemies from upside the head. The leaping attack is a trademark of clubs, and this giant club is no exception. So, we do have the strength to equip it, but not super interested in that right now. Let's see, what else did we have? The plank shield, which is, oh, we got the stone great shield. I'll show you which enemy we got it from, but stability is fucking crazy, but it requires a shit ton of strength, and it is heavy as fuck. I'll show you who we got that from, though. Then we get the plank shield. Makeshift shield built from wood planks provides minimal protection, but at a cost of moderate humiliation. Yeah, that's pretty funny. Use that shit in PvP, you know what I'm saying? Where's the stone great shield? Mossy round great shield used by the guardian of the Darkroot Garden, the Stone Knight. The Stone Knight is a creation of ancient magic, and this shield is imbued with the same power, but is also extremely heavy. So it's great against magic, fire, pretty decent against lightning, and does block 100%, so it's not bad. Let's see, what else did we get? We got the whip, and Nene. I think we picked it up in the last episode, but I never really showed it. Leather whip, not intended for battle, virtually ineffective against armor and tough scales, but quite formidable against enemies with exposed skin. Probably has a bleed effect, maybe? Nope. Alright. And then we got... I know this is kind of probably a little obnoxious here, but we got a new armor set. The Crimson Armor set. Mask of the Sealer. Mask of the sorcerers who flooded New Londo to seal away the Dark Race and the four kings who descended into Dark. It symbolizes their resolve to keep the seal shut forever and their atonement for all who were sacrificed. But two of the three forsook New Londo upon tiring of their duty. And then this is the robe, the crimson gloves, and the crimson waistcloth. It has decent defense. It has good bleed, poison, and cursed resist, actually. It's not a bad set, to be honest. Probably on par with what we're going with. And then we got the tin. We got a new catalyst. The tin banishment catalyst. Catalyst of the banishment sorcerers who flooded New Londo to seal away the Dark Race. In contrast to other catalysts, the metal catalyst qualifies as a weapon as it inflicts physical damage, however small. As you can see, it does inflict some physical damage. Scales well with intelligence. And then three other things, sorry, and then we'll be done. We got a key to the New Londo ruins, which we didn't even need because we had already opened the gate, but it's between Drake Valley and New Londo. Showed you it in a previous episode. The ruins of New Londo were blocked off, for the cursed ghost posed danger to life and spirit, and the legends speak of a terrible dark which was sealed away. And then we also got a Firekeeper's soul, which I didn't even know was down there. so I wouldn't have got this off camera, but I did. Each firekeeper is a blah, 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 so we'll go turn that in here after we get done with this. And then the last thing, a sorcery, which is remedy, sorcery of the red-robed Yolva, one of the sealers of New Londo. Reduce bleeding and poison buildup and undo various poisonous effects, one of the New Londo's unique healing sorceries. Perhaps she abandoned her sealer duty to take her healing arts back to Blighttown. And I think that is it. So let's go trade in our firekeeper soul. And then we're going to talk to a few NPCs. Then we're going to make our way to Darkroot Garden. So now we got Estus Flask plus 2, which is phenomenal. What are we going to rock today? We're going to rock our Thief Mask in Black Leather Armor, all plus 5. Havel's Ring, Ring of Favor and Protection, because we can't get rid of it. Our Raw Battle Axe plus 5. Dude, this thing. Oh, shit. My bad. We need that. 218 plus 92. It's pretty good. It's called 310. It doesn't scale extremely well, but it's pretty legit. It's plenty legit for the foes we're going to be facing. Let's talk
Did
to this
you
guy.
Ring the second bell?
Fucking right, I that rang the second bell.
I must say. But now we have a new problem. It's noisy. It snores, and its breath is lethal. This is no laughing matter, I tell you.
Okay. He's talking about a new NPC that showed up.
That stench. And I was really beginning to like it here. Maybe it's time I do something about it.
Oh, really? Really? What the fuck are you gonna do, bro?
Me?
What are you gonna do? I've never heard that dialogue before. We should probably talk to this Broham.
Well, you certainly are myself.
Does he have anything
Two
new to
things
say?
Are
all right, all right. We've heard that. Let's move. Let's move on.
What's that?
What? Excuse me? Does this guy have anything to say
hello
to us?
There. I'm pleased to see you safe, as always.
Talking.
Paramount is flame. Oh, sorry.
Nope. So. This dude shows up, who is creepy as fuck looking. Hey, bro.
Ah, hello. Was it you who rang the Bell of Awakening?
Indeed.
I am the Primordial Serpent, King Seeker Frant.
King Seeker Frant.
Friend of the great Lord Gwyn.
Sweet man.
Chosen undead, who has rung the Bell of Awakening. I wish to elucidate your fate. Do you seek such enlightenment?
Of course.
Very well. Then I am pleased to share. Chosen undead, your fate is to succeed the great Lord Gwyn, so that you may link the fire, cast away the dark, and undo the curse of the undead. To this end, you must visit Anor Londo and acquire the Lord Vessel.
Fair enough. I can probably do that.
I am pleased to see you well. Is it something urgent?
So we can feed this fucking dude. I don't know what that does.
Those who seek the realm of lords must brave Sen's fortress, a deadly house of traps. Many have gone before you, but none have returned.
Well,
fate has chosen you.
They don't have this badass axe. Anything else you got to say, bro?
Those who seek
all right,
realm.
Yeah. Shut your fucking dragon face, all right? Dude, he's so ugly. Like, is that a mustache? Are those skin tags? I mean, they're disgusting. Reminds me of the scene in Uncle Buck when he's like, here's a quarter. Get a rat to gnaw that thing off your face.
You again? Me? I've become separated from my lady. I've scoured near and far, but no sight of her.
Oh, you're because real good
gone.
At your fucking job,
lady,
bro.
To think I swore to protect you with my life.
Huh.
Your Highness, where have you gone?
Who?
I am entirely to blame for this. Oh, woe is me. I am unworthy. Deathly so.
Okay, yep, you do suck.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Miracles, was it?
I lose myself.
Yeah, let's just leave. I'm not going to buy any miracles since I can't use any miracles. Off to the Darkroot Garden. And actually, probably a boss fight before this episode's over. I'm not 100% sure, but we got probably 20 minutes left of the episode. I realize there has been almost no action. It's been talking, getting a little bit of the story through the NPCs, covering what was done off camera. I get that that's boring as fuck. So for some people it's boring. For some people, I'm guessing they maybe enjoy it, or you know, maybe they didn't focus. Don't you ever fucking stab, sir? Sir? Ah, it was terrible timing. It's all right. For some people, like myself, who played through the game the first time, and again haven't beat it, but played through it, didn't ever really talk to people, didn't even see the importance of talking to people, which is the dumbest thing ever. It's an RPG. Generally, in RPGs, talking to NPCs is a good idea. Let's just stop here so that at least where this is our respawning bonfire. Wicked smart. Well, we're gonna buy an item here from Andre of Astora. We are going to purchase the Crest of Artorias. Crest opens sealed door in the heart of the forest. The door leads to the grave of Sir Artorias the Abysswalker. Many adventurers have left for the grave, but none have returned, for they make easy prey for local bandits. With such dangers, the crest can do more harm than good in the hands of the uninitiated. Yes, I would just like to purchase one, thank you. I'm not actually going to use it here, but I had 20,000 souls. I mean, we'll probably open the door in this episode, but we won't actually go in there because I've got a different plan in mind. I had 20,000 souls. I figured might as well use it now. Actually found a decent farming area, decent area to farm for souls. So here we are, Darkroot Garden. Let's see. I don't know 100% which route I want to take. I'm thinking I want to take this way first. Check some shiz out. Oh, dude, don't be a dick. I'm not sure if you noticed. I wish I would have came this way before we went to Blight Town, because you get tons of moss clumps, which would have been great for dealing with here's Darkroot Basin. So I think we're gonna come across a Black Knight maybe, and hopefully, oh shit, oh fucking right, twinkling titanite and a large titanite shards. That's huge, because then we can upgrade our greatsword again, our Black Knight greatsword. Swads? Let's jump down here. I'm not sure what item this is. Ooh, leather armor. Longbow and feather arrows. Let's check that out real quick. We have a longbow already, but we have the hard leather armor. But do we just have the regular leather armor? Armor made of soft leather. Very common type of protective gear. Wow. Tons of lore to be had in that one, you fucking goofs. Can we jump off this direction? I don't know. I'm pretty sure we can jump off this way. Yep. I'm going to go back up this way, make sure we didn't miss anything. And I don't really... I can't remember exactly where this leads. I mean, I know it leads down to where Havel was, to where the Hydra is in the Darkroot Basin. I think this is where our Black Knight is. In fact, I'm about 99% sure of it. Hey, motherfucker. Oh, you are an asshole. Oh, yeah. Guess what, dude? You're gonna get wrecked here, son. Ooh. Well, that's pretty good. Let's heal. Oh, that was terrible. Gotta run. How did I get another Estus? Yeah, perfect. Ooh, a blue titanite chunk. Sweet. I was kind of hoping for his weapon, because the Black Knight weapons are legitimately awesome. But we'll continue down this path. Pick up whatever items we can. This might be the end of it. Grass Crest Shield. Let's check that out. I think that's actually pretty sweet. Down here. Grass Crest Shield. Doesn't block 100% physical damage, but old medium metal shield of unknown origin. The Grass Crest is lightly imbued with magic, which slightly speeds stamina recovery. We're not going to use it because it doesn't block 100% damage, but it is pretty sweet. Now, we don't want to... Oh, shit. I've totally forgot about this bonfire. And I totally forgot where this fucking goes. Let's light this. Let's light this, bitch. And let's actually see if we can't reinforce our greatsword again. Hell yeah. We're gonna use that to go fuck up that stray demon later. I think this goes into... I totally forgot where this goes. You know what? Let's save that for another time. Because I had a plan and I'm already off fucking plan here. I'm already fucking everything up. Had a great idea, an itinerary, an outline, if you will, of how this episode was going to go, and I've spent the first 17 minutes not doing any of it. Just goes to show I'm pretty... I'll have to write that down as a to-do for later. Explore path at bottom of Darkroot Basin. Elevator / sweet area. I guess I could be sprinting up here. That would probably be advisable. I mean, dude is in shape. I mean, I've run some hills in my day, and it is... They're not fun. I can tell you that much. So I've kind of went away from using my off-camera character to sort of play through the areas that I've got coming up. Just because it's so fucking time-consuming. This cocksucker. Yep, that didn't work well for you, now did it. It's just so time-consuming. I just don't have... It's hard for me to find the time to do it. I don't know if we will get to the boss. It's hard for me to have the motivation to do the off-camera shit. Oh, you fucker. Watch this. Oh, don't you ever. Don't you ever. Did you ever, ever? Ever, ever? Oh, almost missed the item, but didn't. Large soul of a nameless soldier. Not a big deal. There's some cool shit you can see. You can, like, see... Actually, you could jump down right here. I didn't even realize that. But we don't need to, because there's a path we can take. Although, it is obscured / hidden. So let's rest at this bonfire. For those of you that are looking for, like, gameplay tips, this is a hidden bonfire. There's normally a wall right here when you come up to this door where you need to use the Crest of Artorias. To the left, next to this pile of bricks, this is normally a wall. It's an illusory wall. So you hit it with your weapon. It reveals this sweet-ass bonfire, which is super nice because this is a really good area. Let's actually open this. Use our Crest of Artorias. This area through here is a pretty good area to farm some souls. There's a number of enemies that are multiple thousands of souls. I believe they're called... I don't remember what they're called. Fucking ambush bitches. No, that's not what I meant to do. Death. No, I just want to hit this motherfucker. Thank you. And then this motherfucker, maybe? Yeah. Large soul of a nameless soldier. Use that the heavy R2 attack with the axe, and it does the downward strike, and you just hit them on their dome piece, and they did get fucked up. So, this area is tough, but we're pretty well leveled, so it's not going to be that tough, because we can one-hit these guys with our overhand R2 attack, which makes for some pretty easy shit. But when you come down that path, hang a right, a hard right, and you'll see this tree. Notice it's fucking moving. It's creepy, right? It's because it's fucking alive. Then you can kill it, and it reveals this path here. And I don't remember what we get down here, but these fucking stingray-looking bitches give you a green blossom. I forget what the green blossom does. Green blossom is the place to be. Temporary boost stamina recovery. Which is not super surprising. Then we come across another fucking tree that's spinning. Just give him. I mean, it makes sense that we would hit him with an axe, right? Like, that makes a lot of sense. Now, I can't remember. I didn't come down into this area because I didn't want to ruin the surprise. I hear things. I hear movement. I'm gonna hang on. I'm gonna keep to our. Ourselves. That guy'll be easy enough. Oh, really, you fuck? Oh, dude has the longest tongue of all time. It's fine. Better fucking Estus up, because we almost died there. Pretty sure there's an item over here. Yes, there is. Soul of a Proud Knight, which is nice. And I think that's it. Yeah, alright. Probably pick up a green moss from this broham. There is other items over here, though, if I remember correctly. Yep. Sorry, dude. I know it sucks, but it is what it is, man. Nothing. I couldn't remember if there was... There's gotta be something else down here. Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah! I remember. I think we get the wolf ring, dude. The wolf ring's pretty legit. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna get to the moon... the boss. Almost gave away the name of it, but for most people... I mean, Dark Souls is a pretty fucking new game, obviously. I'm guessing most people know... Ooh. Oh, stone great shield. I was hoping for their weapon, maybe? Negative. Wolf ring. Yes. Let's check that out real quick. In fact, nah, let's not necessarily equip it. I forget what it does. I just remember boost poise. One of the special rings granted to the four knights of Gwyn. The wolf ring belongs to Artorias the Abysswalker. Artorias had an unbendable will of steel and was unmatched with a great sword. So, this is not Artorias. It was given to Artorias, so does that mean that person defeated Artorias? Who knows? You know, there's no sure answer, but I suppose it is possible. I don't believe so, though. So I'm not really... Maybe he stole it. Maybe he's a fucking thief. You know, who's to say? Not me. Tell you that much. Do just a little bit more exploration here. Doesn't look like there's really anything else for us to find, so we'll head back. Honestly, maybe we get to the... Did I miss something back here? I don't think so. This opens up, but there's no other paths that I'm aware of. It's just the one, yeah. That is the only place that I think you find those stingray-looking things. It's right there. Like, you could totally go through the whole game and never see that enemy if you, Where is this fucker? Well played, sir. Well played, sir. Well played, sir. I am the world's greatest. Where is that fucking thing? He's here somewhere. Oh, they're right here. No, stop with the fucking blatant just disregard for your life. Oh, shit! There we go. There we go. Whew. Thought we were elite knight helm, leggings, gauntlets, armor, and a blood red moss clump. Again, let's check that out. I don't remember that. Elite knight helm. Helm of a nameless knight, perhaps an elite knight of Astora, although he was loath to give up his undead mission, he perished at the undead asylum and went hollow. So this is the elite knight that gave us the key, actually. Interesting. So we could wear his armor, which is actually pretty cool. Oh, stone great sword. Let's check that shit out, too. Stone great sword. 148 plus does some magic damage of 100. Scales decently well. It's not as good as our other great sword. It's a little less heavy, but does require more strength. So let's go over here. I don't think I missed anything over here, but let's just make sure. We are not going to get to the next boss, but we will. That'll be the first thing we do in the next episode. Fuck that boss up. Dude, Snake Man? I fucking hate Snake Man. Oh, get out of here, bitch. You're gross. Nobody likes your grossness. Forget about this dude. So as you can see, these guys are a pretty good source of souls. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 5 of them in here. So you get 3,000 souls just for killing these guys. Get another, it's about 3,500 souls every trip in here. Approximately. So let's head back to the bonfire. We'll save, or not save, but we'll, so we made some progress. We got some new items. We're actually going to level. Guess what we're going to level? Yep, strength. Actually, I don't know if we can level. Well, we should be able to if we use our souls. Don't ever fucking try to sneak up on me like that again, you cocksucker. Level up. Oh, no, we need 12,000. Wow. You know what? Let's do that. Let's pop. Get rid of this shit. Pop whatever souls we have. Oh, okay. They're already on our quick bar. Our utility belt, our Batman utility belt. Is that enough? Yes, just barely. So we will level strength again, because it's fun. And we're using the Ring of Favor and Protection, which gives us tons of vitality and stamina. So we don't really need. I mean, when we take it off, we're gonna be. It's gonna be a. We're gonna be a bad surprise. It's gonna be bad. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, comment, and we'll catch up with you in the next one. Thanks again. Bye-bye.